Hey, what's up, y'all? Are you trying to rebuild your church website, or maybe you're building one for the very first time? In this video, we're going to be answering the question, how do I set up a website for my church? Coming up. Hey, what's up, y'all? If we are meeting for the first time, my name is Chris Abbott, but all my friends just call me Abbo. Now, I've been in ministry for the last 19 years, and for a good chunk of that, I actually owned a church website company. So I don't build websites anymore, but I do a lot of coaching and consulting in this area. So what we're gonna do in this video is I'm gonna walk you through just kind of six simple things that you need to know about setting up your church website. And I'll actually tell you my very favorite platform to set it up on that's gonna help you get higher up in the Google rankings and help you attract new Sunday morning visitors every week. All right, so number one is your site navigation. Now, a lot of people kind of overlook this, and this is why I like to start here, right? So one of the things that you want to plan out before you actually start building the website is what is the website gonna look like and what are some of the navigation, right? What you don't wanna have is you don't wanna have a ton of pages on your website. It's actually much, much better to have really long pages with lots of information rather than lots of short pages inside of drop-down menus, right? And here's the reason. Now, you have over 80% of traffic on the internet is from mobile, right? So think about how hard it is to kind of click on menus, right? Like on your cell phone, you're clicking into menus, you got drop-down menus and all kinds of stuff. It's actually really annoying, and most people won't do it. They'll just hit the back button, right? And they'll go to the next church website and try to find one that's a little bit more user-friendly. So your navigation is the thing that you want to think about first. So for example, if you're setting up a kids page, instead of having one page for your nursery and another one for your fours and fives, and then another one for your elementary school, and then another one for your youth, right? Instead, what you actually want to do is just have one page and have different sections on that page that talk about every single age group or kids ministry that you have. You're going to get a lot more people who are going to that page and kind of navigating through it because it's so much easier to scroll on a cell phone and read through that page and kind of scan for the age group that you're looking for than it is to keep clicking on drop-down menus inside of drop-down menus. With your navigation, make it super simple and just have much longer pages with more information. Now, the best thing to remember about building those pages is that you want to have lots of media. So lots of pictures of smiling, happy people. It's a great idea to have videos, especially on your kids page where maybe you are introducing them to the kids pastor so they know who they're dropping their kids off with when they come visit your church for the very first time. Think through that navigation, have those longer pages, and make sure that you're not having drop-down menus inside of drop-down menus. This is going to help your site be a lot more user-friendly, and people are going to spend a lot more time on your site and navigating and kind of reading your content if the navigation is super easy. The last thing to remember about navigation is my number one rule of church websites, and that's don't make me think. So whenever someone goes to your website for the first time, they shouldn't have to think about where do I go to find the service times, or where do I need to go in order to figure out the kids ministry, or how do I contact the church, right? You want to make everything very, very simple. Don't make them think. Make everything very simple and user-friendly, because if they're confused, confused people don't visit on Sunday. All right, number two, location and service times. Now, according to a study done by Gray Matter, 43% of church website visitors are on your website looking for location and service times. So once they've already decided that they want to visit, right, and they pull up your website to figure out exactly where you're located and what time is service on Sunday. Remember, don't make people think. What you want to do is you want to have this on your homepage, and you want to have it right below the header. So you're going to have your header as the top thing that they're going to see on your homepage. And right below that, you're going to have location and service times. So it's one of the first things that people see when they first land on your website. This is going to lead to a lot more visitors on Sunday morning. If you forget to put this on your homepage, people are going to be clicking into menus and looking all over your website trying to figure it out. And if you confuse them, confuse people, don't visit on Sunday. So make sure to put this on your homepage at the top, right underneath the header. So it's the second thing that every single new visitor finds when they visit your website. All right, number three, plan your visit. Now, I'm a huge fan of this, and if you are new to the channel, then you can check out some of our other videos. I talk about this a ton, but Plan Your Visit completely transformed my church, and it's helped thousands of churches around the country ever since. So when we first started doing this back in 2017 at my church, we increased our first-time visitors by 42% in the first month, 60% in the second month, 87% in the third month and 113% in the fourth month, right? So literally just by giving people a plan your visit option on your church website, this is going to not only increase your visitors, but it's also going to speed up the natural assimilation process at your church. So you'll see that people will start going through next steps and they start joining your church even faster because they're getting connected from the very first time they visit. Now, again, because we've covered this in so many videos, we're not gonna go into it in depth right now with what plan your visit is, but you need to have it on your website. And the best way to do this is to have a dedicated plan your visit page on the website where you just kind of give an overview and a snapshot of your church. Again, lots of pictures of smiling, happy people, several videos, maybe a video of you as the pastor kind of introducing them and inviting them to plan your visit, and maybe even a couple of YouTube videos of some of your most recent sermons so that they can test drive a service before they ever show up on Sunday. Now, a pro tip is if you really want to be effective with plan your visit is to use some type of a plan your visit button on your website. That way, no matter what page visitors are on, they can always plan a visit from that page. So the best way to do this, in my opinion, is with Text in Church. So Text in Church is some phenomenal software, and you can literally drop just a small piece of code onto your website, and now you'll have a plan your visit button that shows up on every single page. People can click on it, and when they fill out their name, email, and phone number, and essentially schedule an appointment to your church, now you'll actually get a notification so that you can reach out to them, introduce yourself as the pastor, and answer any questions they have before they visit on Sunday. Okay, so before I get to my last couple of points, if you want to learn more about church websites and about plan your visit and how to use social media to attract new visitors to your church on Sunday, make sure to subscribe to this channel and hit that little bell notification because we are putting out brand new videos every single day, 5 days a week. And that way you'll get notified every single time we drop a new video. All right, number four, online sermons. So we alluded to this with your plan your visit page that you want to have a couple of videos so that people can test drive your service. And that's a great way to have that on either your homepage or your plan your visit page, or in my opinion, both. But it's also a great idea to have a page set up where you have all of your recent online sermons. So obviously you can be uploading all of your sermons to YouTube, which is a great idea, but I like to have a place where they live on your website as well. Because again, if someone is cruising your website and they're trying to figure out whether or not to visit for the very first time, then having a dedicated page that has all of your most recent sermons is a really, really smart idea. In fact, there are over 10 million Google searches per year of people looking for online sermons. So if you don't have your sermons built onto your website, then you're missing 10 million chances to share the gospel with people who are actively looking for it. Okay, number four, contact info. So where does someone go if they want more information from your church? This is a great idea to have this on your homepage because again, as people are scrolling through your homepage, they might have some questions, right? Maybe they want to know something about what you believe, or maybe they just have a question about what to wear or about your kids check-in. Whatever it is, it's a great idea to have this in multiple places. So I like to put this on the homepage, right? Right at the bottom, you can literally just have a form, right? That just says, connect with us, right? You have any questions, right? Want to know some things before you visit for the first time? Well, fill out the form below and we'll get back to you as soon as we can, right? So now this is a great way to set up a contact form where it's going to go straight to you as the pastor or to someone at the church, right? Just make sure that however you set this up, this is going to people and they're actually going to see it when it comes in, right? The last thing that you want to do is set up a contact form that nobody ever checks. So make sure that it's actually being emailed to your personal email or your church email, right? Something that somebody's going to check regularly so you can get back to people who are asking questions. It's also a great idea to have a contact page, right? Just because a lot of people are going to be cruising in and out of different pages. They might not be on the homepage, but maybe they've been on your about page or your plan your visit page and they want to ask a question. They're immediately going to look into the navigation, and most people are going to look in the navigation and they'll look all the way to the right of your menu because that's typically where the contact page is. So take advantage of that. Make sure to create a contact page and put it in the top level of your menu all the way to the right. All right, and finally, number six, mobile first design. Now, you're gonna be hard pressed to find some type of a website builder that doesn't have a mobile first design at this point, but it's something that you always want to make sure that you have because more than 80% of traffic from the internet is gonna be coming to your website on a mobile device. So you actually want to design this with mobile in mind first and then think about the desktop. When websites were first being built even 5 years ago, right, people would build a desktop-first experience, and then they would make sure that it also looked good on mobile. But that has flipped now, so you want to make sure that it looks good on a phone first, and then worry about what it looks like on mobile. Again, most builders are going to have a mobile-first design, but it's important to either ask your designer, or when you're looking into a platform, to ask this first. All right, so at the beginning of this video, I promised to tell you my personal favorite platform, and this is actually one of the reasons I don't build websites anymore. There are so many good website builders out there, but my favorite, hands down by far, is Ministry Designs. They have an Omega framework that I am a huge, huge fan of. In fact, I'm kind of obsessed with it, right? And the reason is it's only $97 a month, and you can actually test drive it for free to make sure you like it first, but it's specifically designed for people that know nothing about building websites, and they created it with SEO principles built in, right? So SEO simply stands for search engine optimization. So one of the hardest things to do when you're setting up a church website for the first time is to actually start ranking in Google, because 91% of people never go past the first page of Google. So it's really important to make sure that your website ranks really high in Google. And so this is the only website builder that I've ever seen that is built with these local search engine optimization principles built into the actual website builder. So a lot of it you don't even have to do. It'll automatically build that in and help you rank up in Google faster without you doing a single thing. That's pretty cool. So if you click on the link in the description below, you can actually check out the Omega framework and you can test drive everything for free. Again, I'm a huge fan. It's gonna help more people find your website in Google, and it's really, really easy. In fact, your 80-year-old church secretary could build a website in about 10 minutes using the Omega framework. So click on the link in the description below, go check it out, see if you think it's a good fit for your church.